Tumor cells accumulate hundreds and even thousands of mutations. Most of those mutations happen during the replication of the DNA in each cell division, sometimes incremented due to the exposure to carcinogens such as UV light or tobacco, among others. Most of these mutations are irrelevant for the cell, and it's only few of those mutations that are what we call the cancer driver mutations that are critical to transform a normal cell into a tumoral cell. To find these mutations, in our lab we developed computational methods to analyze the genome of thousands of tumors from patients that have different cancer types. In the sequences, we search for mutational patterns that are indicative of cancer drivers. And these patterns are based on the Darwinian evolution of tumors, which is characterized by variation and selection. Variation is given because every time that cells acquire new mutations, these mutations happen randomly. And selection, when one of these mutations is one of these key driver mutations that confers a selective advantage to the cell. Most of the analysis we have done so far are focused in the genes that code for proteins, which represents less than 2% of the genome. At this moment, we ignore what is the relevance of mutations that are in the rest of the genome, this 98% that we call the non-coding genome. And in our lab, we are interested in discovering these hidden, possible hidden driver mutations in the non-coding genome. We are also interested in developing methods that help oncologists in the implementation of precision cancer medicine. In particular, when a cancer is diagnosed, often there is the sequencing of the tumor genome, and we can see which mutations have these cells. And then we need tools that, that help us to interpret what is the meaning of these mutations, because some of these mutations are relevant to decide what is the most effective therapy for the patient. Working on cancer research is very interesting because understanding what doesn't work in cancer cells helps us go in depth into the cell biology. And also it's interesting because it has the potential to translate into improve cancer therapies. I brought this Earth globe that I bought like 15 years ago in Cambridge. And it has been in my office since then, here in Barcelona and in Cambridge. And I think it's a good representation of how global is science and how aware we have to be of everything that is happening in the rest of the world to make our science meaningful.